Praise God, praise God. It is the last day of January 2023. The Lord has been gracious to us. Wakati wa ukame unaenda tukipungua as we adjust and fitting into the plan of God in the 2023 year that God has given unto us. This is our Streams of Hope program. I want to take this opportunity to invite all of you. I must say a big thank you to Pauline Jubale. I must say a big thank you to Irene Mushemi. Thank you so much, Steve Mwinde. And all of you that are watching the program and pending your comments on that page, may the Lord richly bless you. What a joy to know that there are people whose lives are being transformed. I also want to say thank you so much to the guy behind the cameras, Jonathan. You do a good job, and may God bless you. And above all, I pray that he bless you with something like a good wife. At least, uweze kupata zile, we call them the hutiabilities and mutabilities. So... So I must say thank you so much. I really appreciate it. We are a team in this, and we cannot do it alone. Our topic today is the five reasons on why seek God. Five reasons why seek God. If you have not subscribed to my YouTube channel, tafadhali, hit that subscribe button. Pen your comments down there. I will read them and I will appreciate you. So five reasons on why we seek God. And I know there are many, but I have picked five. On the comment section, you can be able to add more and more. Now, seeking God is a serious business. Many people do not understand the power of seeking God. They don't understand why seek God. Because we are like, anajua mashida zetu. He knows where we are. He's the God who sees the end from the beginning. You know, life has been cut out, so why seek? But I want us to know that there are key reasons on why God desires to seek him. And my reason number one is that it is the foundational reason for our deliverance deal. It is the foundational reason of the deliverance deal. And the Bible is very clear. In his word, Exodus chapter number 9 from verse number 1, the Bible says, "Then the Lord said to Moses, go to Pharaoh and say to him, this is what the Lord, the God of the Hebrews says, let my people go so that they may worship me." God desires us to worship him. He desires us to honor him. He has brought us out of the land of Egypt so that he can be able to bring us into the land of the promise. And he knows the journey from the land of Egypt to the land of our settling. For the children of Israel, it was Canaan. For me and you is the kingdom of the heavens. God knew that there were things that he needed to work in us. There were things that he needed us to learn along the journey. And without which, if we do not seek him, we cannot be able to understand. Particularly on matters to do with this kingdom that God has called us unto. You know, there are those hidden things in the word of God. Actually, the Bible says things that eyes have not seen, ears have not heard. In 1 Corinthians chapter number 2 and verse number 9, you know, he says those things that ears have not heard, that ears have not, eyes have not seen, are the things that he has kept for the righteous ones. But you know what? Many of us do not know them. No wonder we glop in darkness. No wonder we feel like we can pursue the things of this world, because that promise, the purpose of our deliverance is not so clear to us. So we need to seek God, because it's part of the deliverance deal. For the children of Israel, it was a physical journey that they had to journey up to the land of Egypt. But for me and you, it's a spiritual land. It is in the heavenlies. And we have not been left without a helper. The Holy Spirit is resident within us and willingly helping anybody who desires to know much about the land of our calling, the place of our destination. The 12 spies were actually sent to go and do a diligent search on this land. 10 brought a positive report and 2 brought a negative report. Now, when we do not seek the land appropriately, we end up coming up with a wrong or a bad report. But when we understand scriptures from the beginning to the very end, we are able to come up with testimonies like the 2 spies who even came with the evidence of what God had spoken to them about the land, the grapes, They said, this land indeed, as big as he had promised. It is flowing with milk and honey. And as he had said it, there are also giants. But our focus was not on giants. Our focus was on God. Look at where we are as a church today. We are at a place whereby we are focusing on our giants. We are focusing on chasing the devil, chasing the demons. And we forget that the promise that God has called us into, there is a big land. It's flowing with milk and honey. In other words, God is calling us to focus on the real deal of our deliverance. As God establishes a kingdom in desire that me and you will settle down in that coming kingdom. It was part of the deliverance deal. So we need to commit ourselves to seeking God because God desires that he may dwell in our midst. He desires that he may dwell in our minds. He desires that he may dwell in our hearts. You can imagine, our God does not want us to walk without him. So because it is the deliverance deal, God has called us to seek for this land whose maker and builder is God. Look at the children of Israel, or the heroes of faith. The heroes of faith died, but they saw the promise from afar. They would embrace it. They would love it. Abraham saw that day, and he rejoiced in the Lord. And what a joy if you can be able to see the end picture, the end goal of our calling, the prize of our calling, the rewards of the righteous. It will give you the momentum. It will give you the grace. It will give you the desire to keep on keeping on in the journey of faith. God has delivered us for one reason, to seek a land. And no wonder the Bible says in Matthew chapter number 6 and verse number 33, seek ye first the kingdom of God and its righteousness. That land is the kingdom, is the establishment of the kingdom. And God desires that our focus are fixed on that promise. Then the other thing he has promised that he is going to add to us. May the Lord deliver us from the deception of the enemy, where our focus is on all these other things, but we forget that one thing that was the deliverance deal, the purpose of our calling, the establishment of our kingdom, and the Lord Jesus Christ settling down with a procured bride from the church, ruling again in this earth from the heavenlies with the church or with the bride of Christ, and down here with the children of Israel, realizing that which God has promised to Abraham, that your descendants shall possess the gates. They shall possess the heavenly gates and the earthly gates. Is a spiritual implication of the climax of scripture, the establishment of the kingdom of our God. Number two, why should we seek God? We need to seek God because God desires to dwell in our midst. Then number two is intimacy. Intimacy. God desires to dwell in our midst. Exodus 29 and verse number 45, the Bible says, I will dwell among the people of Israel and I will be their God. He has desired that he may dwell in the midst of the children of Israel and he will be their God. He desires to dwell in our midst. He desires that we sanctify him in our hearts and allow him to rule and reign from our hearts, that he can be the Lord of our lives. God desires to fill our minds. Can you imagine? As the Bible says, we are the temple of the Holy Spirit. He just does not want us to give him our hearts. He wants us to give him our minds. Hebrews chapter 8 and verse number 10. For this is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel after those days, declares the Lord. I will put my law into their minds and write them on their hearts, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people. Allow God to control your mind. Allow God to fill in your mind. Allow the word of God to saturate your mind. God desires that he can be the God of our hearts, the God of our minds, the God of our lives. And again, why intimacy? Because God desires to walk with his people. Leviticus 26 and verse number 12. And I will walk among you, and I'll be your God, and you shall be my people. What a joy when we allow God to work in our midst. God desires a functional relationship with his people. The Bible says in Matthew 22 and 37 and 38, Jesus reaching out to the disciples is telling them, you love me with your heart. You shall love the Lord God with all your heart and with all your soul. He was reminding them of the commandment. It is with all their heart, with all their soul. And we know that the relationship of the children of Israel is for a purpose of teaching us, because all these things have been written to us as an example, we who the end of the ages have come. That is 1 Corinthians chapter number 1 and verse number 6. He wants a functional relationship with us. God wants intimacy with us. He wants to see the inner beings of us, intimacy. You know, intimacy means intimacy. And let me tell you, today our God is knocking, and he would want to dine with us if only we are willing to open our hearts. Revelation chapter number 3 and verse number 20. God is not impressed by our casual relationship with him. He wants to dine with us. He wants to dwell in our minds. He wants to dwell in our hearts. He wants to walk with us. He does not want you to walk alone. He knows that this world is a destroyed world and is meant to destroy us and to pervert us. But he wants to be right at the center of the businesses of our lives, the mind, the heart. And you know what the beauty is? When you allow the Lord to have your mind, your heart, is that you're able to hear the voice of God. You are able to enjoy the company of God. You are able to dine with the revelations that is full in his own word. Colossians 2 again, very clearly that in him are hidden the true treasures of God's word. And these true treasures are actually only revealed to them that are walking together with him. God desires intimacy. God desires to spend time together with us. God desires to dwell in our midst. He desires to be part of everything that we do. Number three, why do we seek God? That we may know his ways. We may know his ways. Let me say this. When we give our life to the Lord Jesus Christ, our spirit man is born again. But do you know our soul man is not born again? And he keeps on speaking to us, diverting us from the focus of our purpose of calling, diverting us from the word of God. Exodus chapter number 33 is very clear about the life of Moses. When you look at Moses from verse number 11, this is a man who is seeking God. He desires to know the ways of the Lord. He desires that the presence of God may go together with him. He desires that the glory of God may go together with him. He desires that he understand the heart of God. Psalms chapter 86 and verse number 11, teach me your way, Lord, that I may rely on your faithfulness. It's only after knowing the ways of the Lord that we are able to rely on his faithfulness. When you discover that he has no agenda to afflict you for nothing, it's for purposes of maturity. It's for purposes of growing us into sons. It's for purposes of preparing us for the coming kingdom. And then you give him an undivided heart that you may walk in the fear of God. When you see the way God provides, when you see the way God divinely intervenes in our situations, teach me your ways. I need to understand you, sovereign God. I need to understand why you do things the way you do them. I need to understand why you choose at times to withdraw blessings and at times you choose to provide. I need to understand why at times I ask questions and you are quiet. And the psalmist is saying, when I understand that, then I will be able to rely on the faithfulness of God. I want to know the ways of the Lord so that even when I am afflicted, I can say together with David, I was glad that I was afflicted. I want to reach to a point where Joseph reached with all the things that were happening against his life, being sold by the brothers, one point in the pit, another point in Potiphar's house and in prison. Yet he's able to write and say, now I know that this was done for good. I want to come to that place where I can boldly say, I now know that all things work together for good for they that love the Lord and that have been called according to his purpose. Do you know the ways of the Lord? Do you want to understand the precepts of the Word of God and the Word of God itself? Do you want to have the mind of God? Seek him. There are times we don't even know the way to take. There are times we are in what we call an ethical situation. It's not a yes or a no answer, but you know you are in a dilemma. Isaiah 30 and verse number 21, the Bible says, when you turn to the right or to the left, your ears will hear a voice behind you saying, this is the way. Do you know when you seek the Lord, you are able to understand what God is doing in your life? And those who seek the Lord lack no good thing. Psalms 34 and verse number 10. When you seek the Lord, you know when to move on. You know when to stop. Going through a storm, you will not go down. God is working out. One thing that I know, one thing that I have found over the years I've related with God, that God is working out something. Are you in a dilemma? Allow God to take over your life. He will give you a direction. There is something about seeking God that is connected to knowing his will. And you know, we are living at a time whereby every way seems to be the right way. Proverbs 14 and verse number 12, there is a way that seems right to a man, but it ends up into death. Young people, there is a way that looks like it's a good way, but I want to talk to you. Not every way is the right way. I know our children have gone back to school. I know we have been left behind here, but I want us to know that we need to teach our children to understand that as much as the world is offering freedom without boundaries, they should not yield to freedom without boundaries. Adam and Eve were created and they were put in a garden, a land, that a place that had freedom, yet with boundaries. They need to be taught. We need to grow up our children to know lesbianism is evil. We need to bring them black and white. Homosexuality is evil. We need to reach to a point where we boldly declare sex before marriage is evil. There is a way that looks and seems right to a man, but it leads to destruction. We need to seek God that we may know his ways. I know you're looking at me and saying, mama mezeka, you know, sisi ni watu wa madigital. But I want you to know, it doesn't matter what development takes place, socially, economically, technologically, God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. The Word of God is saying the same thing over and over again. The methodology may change, but the Word is the same. Paul desires to know God. And he says in Philippians 3:10, I want to know Christ. Yes, to know the power of his resurrection and participate in his suffering. Can you imagine? He did not want to know Christ only in the power of resurrection. Most of us are busy casting the devil. Most of us are busy condemning our hard moments. But Paul is saying, I don't want to only know him for the power of resurrection. I want to know him and participate also in the suffering of our Lord Jesus Christ and becoming like him, even to the point of his death, the death of his own flesh on the cross. Number four, why should we seek God? Our iniquity needs to draw us to God. We have iniquities standing in between us and God. Isaiah 59 verse number 2, but your iniquities have separated you from your God. Your sins have hidden his face from you so that he will not hear. And why do we seek God? Romans chapter number 1:18 is very clear. For the gospel reveals the righteousness of God that comes by faith from start to the finish. Why are we seeking the Word of God? Because it is the Word of God that is going to reveal his righteousness.
David says in Psalms 51 and verse number 5, behold, I was born in iniquity. And Romans 1:18 is saying that we need to allow the gospel to reveal that iniquity in us, to reveal that wickedness in us, that we can be able to walk in righteousness, a work that comes from walking in the faith. Verse number 18, the Bible says, the wrath of God is being revealed from heaven against the godlessness and wickedness of men who suppress the truth of their wickedness. When we seek God, we cannot be able to suppress the truth. God's righteousness will be revealed in our midst, and our iniquities that has caused us to turn a deaf ear on godliness will be able to quicken our ears, and we will be able to incline in God one more time. Seeking God bring us back to the right order of inclining in unto righteousness. But we seek him because we are aware of his compassion. So even as we seek him, we have an assurance that he is a compassionate God. Micah 7:18, the Bible says, who is a God like you, pardoning iniquity and passing over transgression for the remnant of his inheritance? He does not retain his anger because he delights in steadfast love. We seek him because we know that even in our iniquity, as our righteousness is being restored again, our God is able to hear us because he delights in steadfast love. Lastly, why do we seek God? Why do we seek God? We seek God because it helps us set a spiritual alarm. It helps us set a spiritual alarm. Look at what Hosea chapter number 10 and verse number 12, the Bible says, so for yourself righteousness, reap steadfast love, break up your fallow ground, for it is time to seek the Lord that he may come and rain righteousness upon you. The setting of an alarm, the seeking God, causes us to set our hearts in a manner that will rekindle the desire for righteousness one more time. God is desiring that we seek him and remain focused, Deuteronomy 4:19, and take heed lest you lift your eyes to heaven, and when you see the sun and the moon and the stars, all the host of the heaven, you will feel driven to worship them and serve them, which the Lord your God has given to all the peoples under the whole earth, the whole heaven, as a heritage. Seeking God helps us to stay focused on God and not on his creation. We are living at a time whereby we are focusing on the stars. We want to read the stars. We want to see and study the moon and say, what is the moon saying? But when we seek the Lord, it helps us reset our minds and focus on the real thing, on the bigger light, who is God himself. I have shared with us 5 reasons on why we should seek God. The first one is because it is the deliverance package. It is God's original deliverance design for us to be able to seek him. We are seeking God because he desires intimacy with us. Number 3, we are seeking God because we need to know the ways of the Lord. Number 4, we are seeking God because our iniquity separates us with the love of God. And when we seek him, we know he's compassionate. He's going to bridge the gap in between us and him. And lastly, we seek him so that we can incline and reset our mind and our focus on him, away from the sun, away from the moon, away from his own creation, and focus on him as our God. May the Lord richly bless you. It was nice speaking to all of us today. Again, remember to subscribe to my YouTube channel, like and share. Support me. I've been able to water you for some time. Just be a blessing to me by sharing this message and subscribing to my YouTube channel. May God richly bless you. Allow me to pray for you. Even as we bring this to a close, Father, we thank you, we bless you, we honor you. Give us the grace and the hunger to seek you. Oh God, we pray that you will show us your way, even as we seek your very presence. Thank you as we incline our ears into you. We appreciate for this assurance that you will hear us. I commit my viewers into your hands. I pray that God, you will raise such a hunger and such a thirst for these dear ones to seek you.
We thank you and we bless you. In Jesus' name, we do pray. Amen and amen. God bless you. Ciao. Say hi to your loved ones. I love you. Don't forget to pin your comments down there on the comment section. God bless you.